So the process I go through in finding my sound as a drummer, and I think this can be helpful to you guys, is three steps. And I know that sounds too minimalist. Like, how can that be? Well, this is what, you know, works for me, so hopefully it'll work for you. Creation, memorization, application. Creation, memorization, application. That's where everything that I do fits into. So so let me explain this to you. There's a rhythm I play in the first song called Provision. Okay, and I started off writing this rhythm. It's all 16th notes, and it's played with the feet. I play a lot of double bass. I don't know if the camera was showing that or not, but I play with both feet a lot to complement what the guitar riff is doing. So I was working on this rhythm, and I had an idea for what I wanted to do. This would be the creation process. This is fun. This is writing, right? In this case, I was starting with 16th notes on my feet, like a backbeat, single backbeat snare, and like eighth notes on my right hand. Important thing to notice, too, about writing, try not to be distracting with your main hand. I wouldn't play this on my open hi-hat. Why? Because that's so distracting. I have eighth notes down. I can play those, spend a lot of time on those. So I'm going to just put that on the back burner, put that on the, you know, the rim of my drum, or maybe the ride, or something quiet so it's not distracting from what else I'm doing. So eighth notes here, snare, backbeat, 16th notes on my feet. Okay, so as I'm playing that, I'm sort of starting to think, da 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 one E into two E into four E into one E into two E into four E into. I'm just leaving out a couple of those 16th notes. I like that. That's cool. It has a little bit of groove to it. It's 16th notes. It's pretty straight, but it has nice gaps in it. So in my head, I'm thinking this is good. This is up to the standard. I'm happy with this. Okay. Creation. Done. I created it. Now memorization. That means when I sit down at the set at 3 in the morning, someone wakes me up, go play that part, I could sit down half asleep and play it. It's like for many of you that can play the samba, right? You just, I'm not thinking one E and a two, E and a three. I'm not thinking about skipping the E. It's just very natural. That's how you want this part to be. And a good litmus test is you have to play it for a minute. Got to hit a minute. If you can't hit a minute, you're either playing it too fast or you don't have it memorized. So you play it for a minute, you commit it to memory, now you got it. Okay. The last part is my favorite. It's called the application. And if any of these, they all take time and patience, but if any of these requires a lot of time, it's the last one. Because, at least for myself, because I could play this rhythm, say I picked the splash, so like a Lamb of God sound, right? What started here, started on the rim of my drum, now it's on my hi-hat, splash. So I'm not quite happy about that because it's the start of the song. I want it to be upbeat. So I'm going to use snare as what I call a pound beat. Probably not appropriate terminology, but when you're writing music, it doesn't really matter. As long as you remember it, pick terminology that fits you. So I have the rhythm. I'm going to start with a pound. Here we go. Okay, I'm happy with that, and I'm going to keep writing, and I'll show you the different ways that I use this. Okay, creation, I wrote the part, memorization, I memorized it, now I'm going to be applying it in different ways. Same exact foot pattern, it never changes. You have all these different opportunities, right? Three over four on your hands, two-handed blast, all just based on this really simple pattern. And that is the basis for all my writing, for all the sounds that I come up with. Another really good example of this is a song called Spirit Breaker. And there's a part in there I wrote that's mostly linear, except for the first hit. Started with the creative process. I just wanted to play this mostly linear beat. Oh, I like that. That's cool. Okay, so how can I use that now? Okay, that's hi-hat, kick, and snare. Maybe some of those Zildjian Zill bells. Same stick. Floor tom. There's three different ways I'm using exactly the same sticking. And so save yourself, be efficient in your writing, be efficient in figuring out your sound as a drummer by taking a part that you have and don't throw it in the trash can just because you have one version of it. You know, try to explore it. If you really like a pattern that you have as a teacher that you're trying to show your student, or as a student that you're trying to show your teacher or your friends, don't just throw it away because you can play it on your hi-hat, kick, and snare. Try to find your sound. I'd say most times your sound is found in that extra step. Just spend that extra 10 minutes on that part, and you'll start to see your own sound develop as a result of that. Okay? So you have a beat that everybody can play, you take that beat, and now you have a sound that only you can make. And that's really the essence of finding your sound as a drummer on a drum set. So many sounds, so many opportunities. If you lay it out mathematically, it would just be exponentially bigger than what you could even imagine. But it takes time and it takes, patience. Creation, then memorization, then application. We'll be right back.